We have seen that a few months ago in Ireland, certain youth, children, decided to travel to Syria. Arabs and non-Arabs also, they decided to travel to abroad. Why? In their understanding for jihad. In their own understanding, they thought they were going for jihad. And you already know that obviously it was not jihad. You already know that it was fasad, fitna. In Syria, whatever is happening is not jihad, you know that. Whatever is happening in Iraq is not jihad, it's fitna, fasad. It is on the name of Islam, destroying Islam. What jihad is this that you as a Muslim kill another Muslim? What jihad is this? Somebody says, La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah, yet you kill him inhumanely and butcher them. In fact, Islam is that religion which also condemns the killing of non-Muslims. Like right now in Iraq, the minorities, the Yazidis, and we disagree with them, but they are our human brothers and sisters. We disagree with people that are not following Islam, but that does not mean we hate them or we dislike them. No, we disagree. Disagreement does not mean, and unfortunately a lot of time people think disagreement means hatred and negativity. We must hate them. No, it's silly to think like that. The Islam which Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam brought and the Islam which conquered the hearts of millions of people is not the Islam which was conquered, which conquered with sword. Islam did not conquer with swords. It did not conquer people. It conquered the hearts of people. You cannot conquer the hearts of people with swords. You can only conquer someone's hearts with love, with your character, with your kindness, with your forgiveness. And this is why when we look at the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam, despite the fact that he disagreed, and despite the fact that some of the mushrikeen, they were severe in their attitude behavior against him. They were absolutely barbaric against him. But yet when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gets a chance to take revenge, he does not take revenge. This is the manner, the akhlaq of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I will just tell you one example. What to talk about Rasulullah? You know, Rasulullah is like rahmatul alameen. He is the rahma of Allah. Allah says about him, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. What to talk about him? He is the greatest of all creation. But I will give you an example of Imam Ja'far Sadiq. Imam? Ja'far Sadiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He is the grandson of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the grandson of Sayyidina Imam al-Husayn radiyallahu anhu. A man came to him, and this man could not find any place to stay. So he knocked the door of Imam Ja'far Sadiq's house. Now this man tried everywhere else, but he was being searched. And there were people searching for him as soon as he is found to bring him to the ruler so he can be killed. This man was among the people who were in the army of Yazid who fought against Imam al-Husayn radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He was in the army of the Yazid and of the evil ruler who killed Imam, who martyred Imam al-Husayn radiallahu anhu. He was among that army who was participated in shedding the blood of the household of the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, of Ahlul Bayt. This man, even he himself, does not find a place suddenly in his life, and he is being searched. He goes to Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq, and he goes to Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq and changes his appearance a little bit. So Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq will not recognize him, because he knows about the kindness of the household of Rasulullah. He knows about the rahmah of the compassion of Ahlul Bayt, the generosity of the family of Rasulullah. So he goes there. And when he goes there, Imam Ja'far Sadiq opens the door, welcomes him. And in his house, Imam Ja'far Sadiq himself orders his wife to cook. And he then serves the food to this man. The night, Imam Ja'far Sadiq lets him sleep on the bed. And Imam Ja'far Sadiq sleeps on the ground. The next day, this man was going, and because his heart was very heavy, he was very heavy, and he thought, Imam Ja'far has not recognized me, otherwise he would never have such a behavior with me. He would never have welcomed me like this. So before he goes, he says, Imam Jafar, he says, I don't know, I don't think you have recognized me. He says this, Imam Jafar Sadiq. At the same time, Imam Jafar Sadiq says, stop. Stop. He says, Wallahi, when I opened the door, I recognized you as one of the killers of my grandfather. I recognized you as those who fought against my father. I recognized you as those who killed my family members. But I am the blood of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We have been taught, even if someone is an enemy, we open the door and he comes to our house, we welcome him. And he says, I served you knowing that you killed my family, knowing that you participated in that army who killed and butchered my family. Yet, remember, you follow someone else, but I follow my grandfather Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the akhlaq of the Ahlul Bayt. This is the Islam we are supposed to follow. Wallahi, this is the Islam we are supposed to follow. So I was saying that some people traveled to Syria and Iraq thinking they were going to join jihad, and these poor children, youth of Ireland, were brainwashed by scholars who came. What scholars? By misguided people who are misguided and who misguide. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ that لَا تُفْسِدُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ قَالُوا إِنَّمَا نَحْنُ مُسْلِحُونَ. When you tell them, don't create facade, they say, oh, we are just guiding people. They came from England, and they recruited these youths, youngsters, and told them, look what is happening, jihad in Syria, and you must now join them, and you will go to Jannah, you will make a difference to the Ummah. And some of them were children of doctors, medical doctors, very respected, educated people. But unfortunately, what happened is that they went and they got killed. They got killed. And the parents until now are very, very sad. The parents, some of them did not even know the child is gone. When the child is in Syria, he calls and he says, my father and my mother, I'm here. I'm doing jihad for Allah. Let me tell you this hadith. This is the and they went, these children went, they were misguided. They were misguided. We ask Allah to forgive them. We ask Allah to grant them Jannah. We ask Allah, based on their intentions, innamal a'malu bin niyyat, even though they did wrong, may Allah forgive them. Now, the hadith I want to tell you about is an amazing hadith. A person came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, I want to go to do jihad. He says, Ya Rasulullah, I want to do. And Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu qala aqbala rajulun ila Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam faqala abayi'uka ala al-hijrati wal jihad. I want to go on jihad, or I want to migrate for jihad, right? Similarly, like his children. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala, asked him, fahal min walidayk ahadun hayyun? The Prophet asked him, is one of your parents alive? And he said, Naam. He said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yes. In fact, both of them. Bal kilahuma hayyun. They are both alive. Qala, fatabtaghi al-ajr min Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, do you want to do this act of jihad, act of migration, for the pleasure of Allah? And what is your niyyah? Is your niyyah for the pleasure of Allah? It is your niyyah to please Allah. And he says, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yes, na'am, yes, I want to get the reward and I want to please Almighty Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commands him. This is a hadith in Imam Bukhari and Imam Muslim's Jami' al-Sahih al-Muslim. Muttafaq alay hadith. And the Prophet commands him, قَالَ فَرْجِعْ إِلَىٰ وَالِدَيْكَ فَأَحْسِنْ صُحْبَتَهُمَا. The Prophet commands him, go to your parents. Go to their company. Go back to your parents and be kind to them. Being kind to them is the thing that will please Almighty Allah. Not going for so jihad. Even that was real jihad. That is the jihad at the time of Rasulullah. It wasn't Syria. It wasn't the facade of today. It was real jihad. But despite real jihad, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam commanded those whose parents were old, don't go. If you serve your parents, for you this will be jihad. You will get the reward of jihad. Sayyidina Awais al-Qarni, one tabi'i. You have heard the name of Awais? Sayyidina, and you know, unfortunately, these fasadi, these extremist militant terrorists. They are such horrific, such barbaric, that they in Yemen, in Syria, they have bombarded the shrines of Sahaba, the shrines of Anbiya, the shrines of Awliya, and they have even bombarded and destroyed the shrine of Awais al-Qarni.